Hi there. As you've opted to teach environmental science or science at the Tamarind Tree School, a warm welcome to you. Teaching science or environmental science at Tamarind Tree does not entail that you should have any formal training in that subject. Neither do we expect that you should be a domain expert in it. However, we do expect that you should have complete knowledge of your subject and you should have a passion for it. We also expect you to be willing to learn over and above what you already know about this subject. I will guide you through how to make a course on this platform. Let's begin. First, let's talk about the philosophy of learning science. The field of science demands, especially at Tamarind Tree, that the subject should make the child curious and inquisitive and explorative of his surroundings. The student should not end up learning definitions and chemical formulae by heart. So make sure your course does not sound like a digital textbook. Be sure to include activities which encourage observation and experimentation by the student, such that these qualities will develop in the child. Secondly, the topic that you teach should relate to the learner. So while it is important to teach concepts and terminologies, which of course science is full of, it is equally important to relate these to real life applications. The learner will learn in the true sense of the word only if the topic is related to his or her day-to-day life. Now let's talk about some pedagogy. As mentioned earlier, you should not end up sounding like a textbook. You should come across as an enthusiastic and a curious person, as curious to learn about this topic as much as the learner you are addressing. You should develop a style and a screen persona that will make the learner come back to your classes again and again. Secondly, while it is important to teach concepts and terminologies, do not end up using a lot of jargons. If you ever need to use a jargon, be sure that you are able to explain it in a simple and easy to understand language. At the Tamarind Tree School, we do not believe that the teacher is a central repository of knowledge. We also do not believe in hierarchies. A teacher like you should be as much a learner himself or herself. If at any given point of time during the class, a child raises a question to which you do not have an answer, it is absolutely all right to admit that you don't know the answer. But make sure that you find out the correct answer and share it in the class the next session. Also, make sure that the course, your learning material, and your conduct in the live class is warm and friendly and does not have any hint of a patronizing approach. Now, let's get down to course creation. As we follow the NCERT syllabus, the first thing that you're expected to do is download the textbook and the relevant chapters from the link given here. You will go through the chapters and all the question answers and assignments given in the textbook. The next thing you will do is to split this topic into a number of subtopics that will become a part of your session. You will share with us your ideas of what you intend to take in each of these sessions. Next, you need to develop some learning material. Now, this learning material could be in the form of short explanatory videos, presentations, or some interactive activity. Do not restrict yourself to just one resource, but you could choose a couple of resources in combination as the learning material for each session. At the end of every session, you need to engage the child with certain activity. These activities could be in the form of an assignment, a quiz, or a discussion forum. All children love some challenges. So make sure that your activity, whatever it is, should include some challenging tasks. Of course, these should be from within the scope of your learning material. Now that you know how to create the course, let's begin making one. If you have any doubts or questions, please feel free to ask for advice and guidance in the forum within the course. Happy creating!